Okay, in this tutorial, I'm going to walk through basically the downloading and setting up the OPML player, or the podcast player, as it's affectionately known. And then I'm going to walk through downloading an OPML file and putting it into the proper directory so that it'll play correctly through PlayOn plugins. The first thing that you're going to do is download the podcast plugin. So you're going to go into the PlayOn plugins site. The first thing you're going to want to do is sign up for an account, because to be able to download anything, you need an account. Then you're going to go to the download section of the website. In that section, we're going to look for the podcast OPML player. And inside there, we're going to go down to the very bottom of the first post, and you're going to see on any plugin, really, that's where everything lives. But effectively, we're going to right-click and save as the podcast.zip file. And what I like to do is save that to my desktop. Makes it easy for me to move things around and delete it and know where it's at and be able to find it. Then we're going to go ahead and minimize that, and you're going to see that there's a podcast. Now, I'm running Windows 7. One thing to note is that Vista is very much like Windows 7 as far as pop-ups and warnings. So whenever I talk about that, it's going to be the same for Vista. If you're using Windows XP, chances are you're not going to get those pop-ups and warnings that I'm going to get. So just skip some of those pieces of the tutorial, but they definitely work on Vista and or Windows 7. So now that we have the zip file, I'm going to go ahead and open that with the Windows zip tool, and we have podcasts and podcast plugin. Now this is the plugin and this is a folder. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up another folder in Start Menu and Computer. In XP, you might have a My Computer on your desktop, or the menu might look slightly different, but basically you want to get to the area where you see your C drive. You're going to go into the C drive. You're going to go into, if you're running a 32-bit version of Windows, or if you don't know, then you only will have the program files, chances are. If you're running a 64-bit version of Windows, be it XP, Vista, or Windows 7, there'll be a program files, which all the 64-bit software goes into, and then a program files x86, which all the 32-bit files go into. So the media mall software, the PlayOn application, is actually located here. So you're going to go into that folder, or the program files if that's all you have, and go to the media mall folder and then the plugins folder. Now inside there is where all your plugins are going to go. Obviously, this is a fresh machine. I don't have any plugins. So what we're going to do is grab these two files and copy them over. Now in Windows 7 and Vista, here's that pop-up. I think Vista might actually ask you two or three. You're going to need administrative privileges. So if you don't have that on your box, you need to talk to somebody that can do it for you. And you're going to click Continue. That's going to copy the files over. And you want to wait for them all to copy over from the desktop. I'm running this on a virtual machine over a network, so it's probably a little slower than your machine will be. When you open up the podcast directory, what you're going to see is the PlayOn plugins community has put together a base set of OPML files that come with the podcast plugin. If you don't like any of these, you don't want any of these, you're not interested in some of these and only others, you can always click and delete the ones that you don't like, hit continue, they disappear, they won't show up in your media player. So that's how you can kind of control which ones are shown and which ones are not. Now there's a template one here, and I'll talk about that in another tutorial that I'm going to do on creating your own OPML files. And then let's go ahead and go back to the PlayOn Plugins website, and if we go back to the home, and let's say I want to start adding some content to this. I know I saw some OPML files that were uploaded here that really intrigued me. I'm into sci-fi, so let's check that out.
When you click on sci-fi, you're going to go to that particular section and click the subject that you're looking for, whatever that might be. And then you're going to go to the bottom of that post and right-click and save target as.
What I like to do is save that to my desktop. The reason I save it to my desktop is if you save it directly to the folder, the OPML folder, it won't work because you need administrative privileges to make that work. So we're going to go ahead and download that to that folder. And then we're going to take Stranger Things TV and drag and drop that into the podcast folder that we talked about earlier. It's going to ask you, are you sure you want to do this? Do you have the permissions to do this? You're going to say yes, and boom, the file falls over. Okay, now I can add as many files as I like. And as soon as I'm done, then effectively to make all of those show up on my player, there's one key element you have to do, and that is to go to Start, Programs, PlayOn, run the PlayOn settings, which will tell you, oh, you need to run it as administrative privileges. You give it that, or XP, it won't do that. You let PlayOn load. And the most critical thing on installing any plugin or changing anything, adding an OPML file, editing an OPML file, changing anything, is if this is running, you want to stop it and then start it. And that effectively refreshes all the new plugins into the PlayOn application so that your players can see it. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. If you have any comments or suggestions, please leave them in the notes below. Thank you for watching. Bye.